The WA resource industry is absolutely booming. There's opportunity for everyone. And if you'd like your slice of the action, come down to the likes of AusCom Training, who will give you your national accreditation on driving this big machinery and getting your shortcut into the mining industry.
This program is very popular and not only helps people get into the mining industry through an easier path, it's responsible for changing the lives of many Indigenous people. Bob McNair has played an integral role in putting this program together, and Jason caught up with him.
Jason, we've set up AusCom pretty much to try and prepare operators or new people to the industry so that they fit into the load and haul cycle or a construction or civil site in the Pilbara or wherever else they're going to be employed. We've tried to cater for all individual operations, loader, dozer, grader, excavator, dump truck. We're finding that a lot of the people in industry are struggling to get dump truck operators and just general operators for machinery. And there are a lot of people out there in WA and the eastern states who are all trying to get into the industry who may have little or no experience. And we're setting up basically to try and capture that market and to prepare these people so they can enter into the industry.
So there's obviously a lot of different people that want to get into the industry. What sort of age groups and what type of people are you seeing coming through?
Jason, there's several types of groups that actually are interested in getting into the industry. Firstly, there's the private stream who fund themselves through the courses, and usually they're people that are inexperienced and people that see that as a way of getting into a higher paying job. The second group is the group of corporate people. We do a lot of corporate groups for different projects starting up, preparing people to go. And the third group is the Indigenous group, which we take a lot of pride and effort in developing. And that's what we call our Stairways program. And the Stairways program takes Indigenous employees from different groups, from different employers, and we process them through to a full certificate to in the surface extractive industries. That is normally funded by a government body, DUA, and the corporate bodies themselves.
So Bob, any chance we can meet some of the students and hear their stories?
Absolutely, we've got some great people to meet. Come this way.
Lester, it's an absolute hive of activity here at the moment. What's your involvement?
Yeah, well, I correlate all this, going through resumes and getting these guys and girls together ready for me to come out here to AusCom, where we run them through it. And we train them on the roller, we start off, and then we progress to the haul truck as we got over there. During the course of the 3 weeks, we do a fair bit of theory for the first week, then we get into the practical part, a component of it. And by the time we finish, over the 2 weeks out here, I work out where they're best suited. There are some guys that haul trucks a little bit too much for them, and vice versa the roller, so we start up on that. Also, we try to work out which type of work would be better for them suited, whether it be civils or mining. Now, civils is a 4 weeks on, 1 week off. Mining is 2 weeks on, 1 week off.
Hey, my name's Norman Hayes. I came through the power program. Before I came over here, I came from a country town called Bairnsdale in Victoria. First went to civil, found it a bit hard being away 4 weeks at a time. So changed to mining, so it's a bit more easier for my family to be able to afford better things. I've got myself a new car. Wife loves it over here, the kids love it over here. I want to be over here for the next 20 years. I want my kids to, you know, whatever direction they want to take, but hopefully they'll want to do something like this to help themselves financially. So. If you can take it, take it. It's a good opportunity.
Now, normally when I go to a mine site, I don't see too many ladies. You're here, you're enjoying it?
I am. It's a really great experience for me. And since my dad and sister are already on the mine site, I thought it'd be cool.
So how long have you been involved in the mining industry for now?
Since I left high school. So since I was 18, I got my first job on as a trainee at Yarri Mine Site, and it's been good so far. Moved down back to Perth for a couple of years, and this opportunity came up and I took it.
So what's this opportunity that you've got now? You're learning to drive some of the heavy machinery?
Yeah, for the first time, haven't had this opportunity. And it's been pretty good driving the trucks and learning how to operate it and stuff like that, reversing and stuff.
So how do you think, is this going to change your life?
Oh yeah, definitely. It's one for financially settled, and hopefully I'll earn enough money to get my own apartment and stuff.
And how do the family feel about it?
My mum's overexcited. My dad's very proud of me, and yeah, it makes me happy and it makes me feel good.
So what's the future for you?
Probably working until I retire.
Okay.
Yeah. Because it's just great driving a big truck and being in the mining industry. It's good.
So how long have you been involved in the mining industry for now?
I've did a bit of work with on the production side with mineral processing, like the final treatment. With mining, per se, I haven't really done much. That's why I'm in this program.
So what are you looking to do? You've joined the program because you want to get into the heavy machinery?
Yeah, definitely. Always wanted to be a machine operator. And
I understand there's some decent money involved as well.
Money's good, yeah. Big factor.
How do the family feel about it?
They're pretty much all right. Takes a while to get used to being away, but I've done it for a bit, so yeah.
So like anything in the mining industry, you're spending quite a bit of time away from home, but you think the money and the lifestyle will make up for it?
Could do, yeah. Being away, it is hard, but you got to pay the bills at the end of the day.
And so you're looking to make a career out of this?
Yeah, I'm hoping to work my way up and see where it takes me.
And so where do you see yourself in 5 years?
I'm hoping to be up there like a supervisor or even a leading hand, that'll be cool.
So you've actually already done some work up at Cape Lambert?
Yeah, I was a grade 3 construction worker. Just mainly doing labouring jobs, a bit of traffic control.
And so outside of work time, you can get a bit of fishing in?
Yeah, the fishing up there is great. You get 13 days on when you're on civil, so it's a 4-week roster. So you get RDO, and on that RDO, yeah, you can do a bit of fishing.
If there's space, I guess everybody's out there fishing.
Yeah, well, that's another thing.
So you were previously in the mining industry, you went off and did something else, and now you're coming back into it.
Yeah, and I was when I was younger, I spent 10 years as a mill operator, and then went away for 20 years and worked in the construction industry. So, and this is way back, yeah.
So why are you heading back in?
A lot of things. Money is obviously a big factor, but I want to retire in X amount of years, and this is the quickest way to do it.
So the money's there, obviously. Is there a lifestyle thing as well? I mean, are you looking forward to going out to the mine sites and having that different way of life?
Yeah, it'll be hard to start with because I'm married, obviously, and for my wife it'll be hard. But she's a very active person, so this is like we've been over here now for 3 weeks, and she can handle it. So
how do you think she's going to feel about living, out at one of the mine sites? It can be a reasonably lonely existence, but there's something of a community.
No, actually, she's going to stay on the Gold Coast, and I'll just commute back to the Gold Coast every 2 weeks.
Right, so you're going to be 2 weeks on, 1 week off?
Yeah.
So why have you chosen to come through this course? Is it an easier path than going straight up into the mines?
I wouldn't have got into the mines through that path, yeah. Yeah, no, this is definitely the only way that I could get in, yeah.
And so how long is the course that you're looking at doing?
This is a 3-week course, yes.
3-week course.
Yeah.
And that will then give you a ticket to be able to go up on the mine sites?
Yeah, it'll give us the basics, and obviously when we go up there we'll still have to do a little bit of training, but it's the only way in, yeah.
Now, Chris, you're a younger fella. You've worked in civil construction before, but now you're moving into the mining industry. I assume it's something to do with the money.
Yeah, it does. It has a fair bit of to do with the money, actually.
So what sort of money were you on previously?
Oh, I was on probably $30 an hour in the civil construction in Melbourne. So.
And we reckon in the mining industry you're going to get a bit better than that?
Yeah, probably five $10 more possibly.
Right, okay. And so are you looking forward to actually getting outside of, say, a capital city and moving out into the country?
Oh, yeah, I actually had a thought about it, but because the money was so good, I loved the city, so didn't really want to leave the city, but because the money was so high, I just thought, yeah, I might as well.
And how did the family feel about it?
Oh, no, they're cool. They're cool. They said go for it. But, yeah, so I thought I'd come straight over.
Now, do you have a partner?
No,
okay.
Single.
So that'll make it nice and easy?
Yeah, nice and easy for me.
AusCom, as part of its training program for new operators, and aside from their Indigenous programs, uses cutting-edge computer simulators to train people from the private sector in the use of machinery from the mining industry. The use of these simulators allows the new operators to gain knowledge and experience in a safe environment. All new operators are required to be assessed prior to moving out onto the full-size trucks, ensuring they're not only competent, but confident in the operation of the equipment. Utilising the simulators allows AusCom trainers to create events such as onboard fires, rain, other traffic and much more to ensure operators are prepared and able to respond to anything. The simulators also have the ability to be adapted to suit various models of trucks used in the mining and civil industries and feel almost like the real thing. They're quite amazing.
The federal government is talking about importing thousands of foreign workers to cope with our mining boom. But why should we import people when one of those people could very well be you?